And thanks again. I think we're ready to go. So as we get started today, just a couple of housekeeping announcements. Just a reminder that if you're listening from your computer, there's a mic and audio option there for you to select in the control panel. And if you can wear a headset, that just helps keep the noise down. Keep yourself muted during the call, so you are in listen-only mode, but I'll take a look for folks. If you have questions, I definitely want to get to those, so you can use the Q&A window in your control panel. And like I said, I'll keep an eye out for any questions in the Q&A window and make sure we get to those. And as we go along today, if you find things that are interesting or you're excited about, please do feel free to share them. Our Twitter hashtag is at Drupal Assos, so feel free to use that and share what you learn as you go through the call today. And as I mentioned, we're also recording this, so if you miss anything or want to share it with your colleagues, you'll get that chance too. So those are our housekeeping announcements. And we also want to tell you, remind you just about some of the events that are coming up that you can get involved in. Of course, we're all looking forward to DrupalCon Amsterdam in just a few weeks now. It gets closer and closer. So we hope that you're all joining us there in Amsterdam, September 29th through October 3rd. Los Angeles will be our next North America Con, and that's going to run May 11 through May 15. And we're really excited to have our first DrupalCon Latin America, which is going to be in Bogota. And that's going to start February 10th through 12th. So if you have business connections down in Latin America or interested in coming down to see what's going on with Drupal in that region, I highly recommend that event. We're really excited about it. And then lastly, once a quarter, we run an event called Global Training Days, where we help organize folks who are interested in helping to grow the Drupal community of developers by providing free and low-cost training. So if you have staff on board who are great trainers, it'd be wonderful for you to join that and help us create the next set of Drupal developers. You can learn more at the URL there and sign up to participate. And the next event is on November 14th, so that's coming up soon. Good deal. So that's what's coming up. What are we going to talk about today? We have a few things that we're going to talk about, actually in a different order. We're actually going to switch this out a little bit. But what we want to do today is just give you a sense, first, of what's going on Drupal.org. As partners, obviously, we ask you to make a commitment to us, so that we can continue to do the work that we do. And we've been especially focused on Drupal.org in 2014. So we want to share with you how the team is growing and what kind of impact they're having now. And then we're going to talk to, we're going to do that with Josh Mitchell, our CTO. And then we'll talk to Joe Saylor, our marketing manager, I got the word out, who is... who's going to be sharing a little bit about what we're doing to help support Drupal marketing and D8 sprints in the community as well. That's our agenda for today. And just to remind you that you guys are in great company as supporting partners and supporting hosting partners and supporting tech partners. You guys do great stuff all around the Drupal community, but we're especially thrilled to have you be part of the association supporter program. And really appreciate the support that you give us, and everything that we talk about here today is because of the work that you do. So thank you for that. All right, so that is my introduction. And with that, I think I'm going to throw things over here to Josh, our CTO, who's going to sort of walk you through some of what's going on with Drupal.org.
All right, well, the first thing I wanted to highlight was the growth of our team. We are all the way up to 10 and a half FTE on the Drupal.org engineering team. That's a pretty significant achievement when you consider that we really only had two full-time people on this as recently as September of last year. We started the growth pattern in October, and we've carried it over with about one hire a month starting in the March timeframe. We've been really excited with the people that we've brought on board. The two most recent are Jacob Perry and Emily Nouveau. Jacob is going to be helping us with a wide variety of things, but he has some great experience with COD, which is conference organizing Drupal, which should help us with our DrupalCon sites. And he also has great experience with Commons, which we hope to put to work on some groups improvements, which are really going to help motivate the community and get them excited about the work that we're doing. Emily is our web designer, and she comes with an amazing set of experiences around user experience, being able to apply responsive designs to a site, and that's a couple of the big things that we're going to be throwing her at the very onset of her starting with us. We have one position left to fill, and we've been actively interviewing for this position. We're hoping to fill it by, say, mid-October timeframe, basically after we get back from Amsterdam. And that's a project manager position that's going to help us help manage our agile project management process and also kind of chip in on some of the technical configuration and ongoing kind of removal of blockers for the dev team, which is a huge part of the project management position in an engineering organization. So we're very excited about this. This gets us up to kind of our full team size, and we'll be able to do some amazing things as a result.
Nope. There we go.
Holly and I had a little bit of a technical difficulty there. So I want to give you a little bit of a Drupal.org update. That team that we've been building out has been very busy. We have been working with the working groups to help us plan a exciting 2015. We've been prioritizing all the features that the community has wanted done for a very long time. And now we have people that can do dedicated work on it and can be really trying to push forward velocity of change on Drupal.org. The big things that we've already launched this year are things like an API. We now have RESTful web services for Drupal.org. It's in kind of its nascent form. We're going to have to work on it a little bit to start integrating it with some other systems. We've also started using some JSON-based data views that will allow us to integrate with some of our sub-sites. We're hoping to, going forward, provide a JSON feed for every DrupalCon so that if somebody wants to build a mobile app, they're able to jump in and grab that data and start working with it. We've also been hard at work moving D8 blockers. So semantic versioning is a big one. The site is all prepared, and we've actually already moved over the Drupal 8 code into Drupal 8.0.x pre-release. So we've already put that in place, and the core developers are already beginning to use that. We are doing some exciting work with redesign, and in DrupalCon Amsterdam, and then shortly thereafter, we're going to be presenting a lot of information about the user research findings. We interviewed over 30 people across the community, and we've also got a couple of web surveys that are coming up that are going to be influencing that as well. It's really awesome to see the feedback that they've given us. It's given us a great way forward. It's going to help with our prioritization, and it will produce some exciting things on Drupal.org. Content strategy is the next piece. We're going to be taking a look at all of the content types that we have on Drupal.org and finding the ones that we're missing, finding the ones that need to be refined a little bit more, and that's going to influence our redesign process a bit more. A couple other things that we've launched out in the past month or two are things such as being able to highlight supporting organizations that contribute code to a project. If you know a project maintainer and you contribute time or money towards the development of a project, you can ask that project manager to include a reference to your organization on the project page. And that will also show up on your organization page with a link over to that project to show how you're supporting the really important code that's going on out there. And that works for any project outside of core or the Drupal.org modules. So basically any contributed module, theme, distribution, work with the maintainer to have them credit your organization for the great work you're doing. We're also doing some continued improvements for Drupal.org around performance. And there's been some exciting things with the CDN. We've seen response time or time for a page to load. We've seen it really, really go down, which is a positive thing, all across the globe. And we're continuing to make small tweaks there. But for the most part, that has been rolled out across all Drupal.org sites and subsites. The last thing I really want to touch on, and I'm going to spend a little bit more time on this and then transition to Joe to let him talk to you a little bit about some of the impact. But Drupal Jobs has been such a positive launch. We've seen incredible uptake by the community. There's already been, actually, I think I have a slide in here a little bit later that tells us the current numbers that we've seen. So it's definitely up the professionalism. I think we've had constant comments about how nice it looks, and I have to give a little shout out to Cheeky Monkey Media. They were the design and implementation team that we brought in for this project, and they did an excellent job with us. It's free for job seekers, and we already have 378 job seeker profiles, which is very exciting. It's all those people in the community who are like, hey, sign me up. There are affordable options for posting jobs, and we've seen quite a few people purchase those. And remember, as a supporting partner, you have a coupon out there right now that you should be using to post your jobs, because you can get, I believe, unlimited job posts at this time through the supporting partner coupon. I'm not going to say what it is, because then everyone would use it. But you have an email in your inbox, and you should use that coupon. There's also branded company pages, and we're hoping that you guys will go out there and grab some branded company pages and use that to highlight your job posts. It gives you a nice little page that shows all the jobs that you have posted on Drupal Jobs. It also gives you an opportunity to put some video and other things that is really job seeker focused, and gives a great opportunity to see your company from that standpoint. There's some powerful search tools built into there. Job seekers have already given us great feedback about the variety of jobs that are out there, how they're being classified. We're seeing a very global approach to job posts. Right now, we're about 50%, actually about 40% US. I think we're in the neighborhood of like 10% UK. And then literally everything else, it's so spread out around the world that percentages don't matter at that point. We've got a very global job board at this point, and that's been exciting to see. We have very elegant tools for employers on the backside to see what posts are getting viewed. You can see how many impressions your post has had, and also how many times it's been clicked through on, which is very powerful. And for those interested, we can actually run a report and tell you how many outbound links have gone to your site if you've posted something and you're curious how much traffic is flowing your way. As a matter of fact, for a couple of our posts out there, we've already seen in the neighborhood of 300 clicks through to the employer site. And that's a really, really great number, especially when you consider that this job board has been out there for a whopping 3 weeks. We launched it on August 25th. So that's been very, very positive. There are 115 job posts on the site right now, which is an excellent number to get started with. We were very excited to see that. That said, I think that there is room for more. And with the search tools, your job posts don't fall away. So definitely jump in there and start using them. A few of the screenshots, you know, I mentioned the search tools. You'll see on the side, you filter search by location, by position. The featured post that you see on the top there, you can actually purchase a featured post for 30 days for, I believe, $89. And that will put your post at the very top of the list. It gives you great impression counts for a very low price. So that's a very cool feature that was added in. But it's, once again, the design has been phenomenal. The response that we've had to the look and feel of Drupal Jobs for a Drupal site. Here's our full product listing right here. Single job post for $199, 5 job postings for $750. I really want to highlight a couple things. That super bundle for $1,900 is a great deal. It gives you basically unlimited job posts for the entire year. It also gives you a branded company page and allows you to promote 5 posts to featured. So that's a pretty cool little feature there. I'm going to stop my sales pitch, though, because I'm getting to sound a little used car salesman-y.
All right, if you have to.
Yeah. I go into my radio voice for these presentations.
You got a good one.
So here's a good example of a branded company page, and there's a couple other branded company pages up on the site. So take a look and see if you want to add one of those to yours. Here's an example of those reporting tools where you can see how many active jobs you have. You can see how many days are remaining on it. Once again, you can count views and impressions, and we give you a percentage on the click-through rate, which is excellent. And you can do that for the last 7 days, last 30 days, last year to date. So take it up a level, look at buying a branded company page, look at buying a featured post. And again, if you go the route of a super bundle, it really is an excellent deal in terms of pulling together a recruiting package for the entire year. So I think at this point, I'm going to hand it over to Joe Saylor, and he's going to talk you through a little bit of the job market survey that was conducted.
Yeah, let me just double check and make sure that I've got Joe, and he's unmuted. So give me 1 second there. All right, Joe, you with us?
I am.
Excellent.
Thank you. And Josh, I am totally sold on Drupal jobs. Nice work.
I've got a good fallback career.
It is an awesome site. I wanted to talk a little bit about a related topic here. You may have seen this yesterday, but in the run-up to the launch of Drupal jobs, we conducted some market research. And there were some really interesting insights in that market research. We surveyed both job seekers and employers, and we decided to go ahead and expose some of those insights in an infographic here. And again, you may have seen this yesterday. We did a blog post and some social media work promoting this. And there is a link to the infographic and to the raw data behind the infographic as well, and you'll get that in the slides later. Probably reinforces what a lot of you already know, and that is that more Drupal talent is needed in the marketplace. 92% of the employer respondents said that more Drupal talent is needed to meet their needs. 40% of employers say they are constantly in Drupal hiring mode, and that probably reflects a lot of you as well. One of the interesting things that we asked was, we asked the job seekers, are there a lot of jobs out there that you see? And generally speaking, they said, well, yes, there are lots of jobs out there. But they also said that a lot of the jobs don't fit my needs. And the top three reasons that those job seekers gave for a job not meeting their needs or not being a good fit was compensation. Relocation, they are not interested in relocating, a lot of them, and a lot of them also want time to work on the Drupal project, so flexibility around time for working on the project is important to a lot of job seekers. But I'll let you on your own time go and look at the infographic, and if you're interested in the raw data from the survey, there's some good information there. So Holly, if you want to go to the next slide. Drupal 8, for news on Drupal.org, you probably know that we are one beta blocker away from a Drupal 8 beta. So that should be coming soon. We are helping to sponsor a Drupal 8 sprint in Ghent, Belgium, which will take place December 10th to the 14th, and we're expecting about 10 to 12 sprinters to participate in that sprint, and that will be on the heels, obviously, of the sprinting that happens in Amsterdam. So some really good momentum on Drupal 8 through the end of the year, and when that Drupal 8 beta happens, we will certainly be promoting that and creating awareness around that beta. Also wanted to point out some content on Drupal.org. That is at /Drupal-8.0. There are several individual pages there for various roles. You may have seen that, developers, themers, site builders, and content admins. And then there's an overview and an FAQ there as well. There's also infographics on all those role-based pages. So if you go to one of those pages, you're going to see an infographic for download that speaks to those individual audiences. And then there's also an overview deck at that link, which is a really good sort of introduction to Drupal 8, and it actually gets into some detail for developers, site builders, and themers in particular about some of the new stuff in Drupal 8. So I encourage you to take a look at that deck. Right now it's very plain. there's no branding on it really, but I'm working on a branded version of that deck, so it'll be a really nice piece that you could take and show to clients or others. And again, I'll be communicating. The deck is complete. So go ahead and go to the next slide, Holly. And then just wanted to highlight a couple of things. Drupal will be represented at the Symphony Live London event in September. Well, actually, in a couple of weeks here. Some folks with a company called Bright Lemon in London will be volunteering to staff a booth there, so it'd be nice to have a presence there. And then also a couple of recent articles I wanted to highlight. This NASA saves millions by moving to Drupal in the cloud. Really great testimonial on what Drupal can do and you know, frankly, the money it can save. That is in Information Week, and it's linked there. One of the commenters on that article said, you know, hey, if NASA can do it, anybody can do this. Really good testimonial there. Another article in Information Week, City of Los Angeles moving 40 sites to Drupal. Encourage you to check that one out as well. And then a nice piece promoting the security of Drupal there, how card.com is securing itself and users with open source. And that speaks specifically to Drupal as well. So some really nice articles, recent articles, that I encourage you to take a look at. And that's it for me.
Thanks, Joe. That's good stuff. Good stuff for sure. And yeah, definitely the deck is a great resource. So for folks who are interested in talking about Drupal 8, as Joe mentioned, definitely check out the deck. And there's lots of great material in there for you to use. So. Well, I just want to round things out here with a couple of more announcements this morning about some hiring that we've done here. Josh talked a lot about the tech team hiring. We've done some hiring in other areas as well. So I just want to introduce a couple of new team members. The first is Philip Bulubar, and he's our new content manager. And so all the amazing landing pages that we're working on, the Drupal 8 landing page, the persona-based landing pages, other key content on Drupal.org, Philip is really helping us drive traffic and make that content findable by the community and folks who are interested in Drupal. And he has a lot of expertise in that area. So mostly I walk by his desk and look at all of the He's always got at least three screens going, one spreadsheet, one Google Analytics, and one Drupal.org. So I think he's on the right path. So Philip, working on content. And then the additional hire that we've recently made is Jess Nelson. Jess is our new sales operations manager. So she is working with Johanna and Don and Megan, whom I'm sure you all are familiar with at this point, just to help make sure that everything that we do from the time that we have a conversation with you about an opportunity to the point where that gets fulfilled by Rachel or, you know, that whole process is efficient and easy for everyone. So we're really excited to have Jess on board, especially because she has a giant Star Wars Lego collection. That's part of my favorite thing about Jess. So yeah, those are our couple new staff members. And now I just want to make sure that we have time for questions that you might have about anything at all that we've talked about here today or anything else that we're doing. So again, you can use the question window and type something in for us there. Hopefully you all have access to that. And if you have, like I said, anything related to what we talked about today or anything else generally that you want to know, we're totally happy to answer those questions. Do you have any questions, Josh? No? Okay. Why did I get up so early? It's a tough morning. All right. Well, I don't see any coming across, but I'll also just extend the offer. Obviously, if you think of any questions later on, you know, feel free to reach out to Megan or myself or Josh or Joe. We're all very approachable and reachable. Just send us your thoughts or questions. We're happy to get back to you at any time. So I think we're done and we can wrap today's call. Any objections? Going once, going twice?
Sold. Wait.
Ah, here we go. One question. Oh, here they come. one question. I missed the intro slides on jobs.drupal.org. Are we supposed to have a discount coupon on that? That is correct, Felipe. As a partner, supporting partners and premium supporting partners, do you have a coupon code for the jobs board? So if you don't have that, definitely reach out and we'll make sure you get that email again with the coupon code. All right. Excellent. And that was it. Got some smiley faces in there too, so thanks. Excellent. So we're going to go ahead and wrap this one. But as we mentioned, we'll make the recording and the slides available to you. You'll get those shortly, so look out for those. And just thank you again so much for demonstrating what it is that makes Drupal the most amazing open source project out there. You guys are so fantastic at providing support in so many ways, and we really appreciate all the work that you do with us. So thanks a lot, and we'll talk to you soon.